Hi, I'm Sam Heck, Development Team Project Manager at ZenQMS. Our team is continuously working to bring you the best experience, and I'm looking forward to sharing highlights from our 2020.2 release with you. Like you, we know that quality is in the details, which is why I'm excited to kick off by showing you our new e-signature flow for our change control issues and tasks modules. First, you'll notice that the journey has shifted. We've redesigned the flow so that the signature now comes at the end of the item review rather than at the beginning. As a result, when you're signing an item, you'll no longer see the green signature box. We've incorporated the signature action into a slider for better readability. You'll also see that we've added a yellow highlight that pinpoints the section you are approving. So, for example, let's say I'm asked to review and sign off on this stage of an issue. From the dashboard, I open the issue. ZenQMS will now automatically scroll to the stage I need to review. I also see that the stage is highlighted in yellow. Once I review the content and scroll to the end of the material, I'm called to action. I can either approve via the green button or deny the stage via the red button. Once I've made my selection, I click to open the signature from the slider. Here I will enter my credentials and submit my electronic signature to complete my review. In the spirit of improving your experience in ZenQMS, we understand that having confidence in finalizing an issue or change control is critical. We've added confirmation that you've finished the final step in a change control or issue. Now, when you reach the final stage of a change control or an issue, you will see verification in the details section. You can see here in my example, the confirmation text, "This project has been completed," in gray. Additionally, whatever stage you configure as your final stage changes from white to gray. And here you will see the indicator, this is the final stage. Now you can have peace of mind with each change control and issue you complete. I'd like to introduce you to our new, more powerful table experience. Before we move into functionality, you'll notice that we've updated the look and feel of the table view. Less lines and more white space means that you can easily focus on the key element, your data. Now let's take a look at the functionality we've added. First, we've added new default columns to create even more useful insights for your quality metrics. Let's say you'd like to track the average time of overdue items. Now you can add completion date and project due date for a quick column comparison. This can also be done in the task full table. Perhaps your metrics are informed by date started, number of days open or to complete, and created by. You can now easily add these from our new column templates. For example, let's say I want to learn how many issues assigned to my team have been open longer than 5 days. I can navigate to the My Direct Reports Issues dashboard, add the Created By and Number of Days Open columns. And as a team, I can see that I don't have any issues open longer than 5 days, but 3 of these issues will be open for 5 days starting tomorrow. And I should take proactive steps to prevent these issues from lingering open.
Thanks for joining me for the 2020.2 review, and stay tuned for future updates.